How many of you have seen Groundhog Day? Yeah, yeah. You remember in Groundhog Day, Bill Murray's character is he's a jackass at the beginning. He's very arrogant and he's very unskilled. And then he gets stuck in the same day, which is pretty funny because that is what happens to you if you're arrogant and unskilled. You end up in the same damn day. That's not fun. And then in that day, he becomes attracted to this woman who's an anima figure. And for years, as far as the film's concerned, every time he approaches her in his arrogant and clumsy way, she slaps him. So there's one scene in the movie where I think it lasts for about 30 seconds, and it's nothing but clips of her slapping him probably 30 times. At that point, you've seen him go through the same day in the continually painful way that he does, and she slaps him in those longer clips. And after a while, the filmmaker gets tired of that and just shows you nothing but the slaps. You know, eventually, he's brought so far down as a consequence of being stuck in the same day and continually being slapped that he falls completely apart, right? Then he tries to kill himself. And one of the very comical things about that movie is that that doesn't work either. He just wakes up in the same day again. And you know, what that means in some sense is that if you're too damn stubborn to change, you will keep running into the same thing over and over, continually. And that's why you're in the same day, because you won't let go of it. And that might drive you even to question the value of your own being, but that's also not a very useful adaptive strategy. You know, and it isn't until he starts to take his rejection seriously that he starts to actually build some real character, right? And then he starts paying attention to the day and finds out that there's all sorts of things that he can do during that day to make it rich and meaningful. And as soon as he does that enough and becomes an expert at it, poof, he gets out of the day, the same horrible day. And so that horrible day is also a representation of the tyranny of the state, because the state is something that's static. So anyways.